Good morning, class. How are you? Welcome to today's lesson. Today's lesson, we are going to learn how to solve radical equations. Radical equations. A radical equation is an equation that contains one or more roots and also have a variable in the root. So if an equation contains one or more roots and has a variable in the root, that equation is termed as a radical equation. Another name for the root is the radical. That's why we call it radical equations. The roots can be a square root, a cube root, or the fourth root. At this level, our concentration is on the square root. Examples of radical equations are 1. Square root of x minus 3 plus 1 is equal to root of x. Then 2. Square root of 3x plus 4 minus square root of x plus 5 is equal to 1. These are examples of radical equations. They are examples because when you look at the first one, we have a square root and we have a variable in the square root equal to something. This makes it a radical equation. Our task here today is to learn how to solve such an equation. Okay? And in solving a radical equation, you have to go through four basic steps. I want you to write the step down for me because we will use it in solving it. The first one, isolate one of the radicals, meaning put it on one side of the equation and all other terms in the other side of the equation. Then, the second step after the isolation, you square both sides of the equation and you simplify it. Then the third step, you square again if necessary, and then simplify again. Then the final step, you put in the value of the solution into the equation to check if it satisfies the equation. So when you go through these four steps, you will be able to solve radical equations. Let's take an example using our first example. The equation is square root of x minus 3 plus 1 is equal to square root of x. I want to first isolate this radical. So I'll keep it here and take the others to the other side. So I have square root of x minus 3 is equal to square root of x minus 1. That's the first step. The second step says square both sides. So I'll square here, then I'll square here. The essence of the square is to get rid of the square root. So x minus 3 is equal to, this is a binomial, so you solve it using the binomial principle. Square the first term, square root of x all squared. Multiply the square by the first term and the second term. Minus 2 root x. Then you square the second term, plus minus 1, all squared. So x minus 3 is equal to x minus 2 root x plus 1. Then we come back to the same thing. Because we have a radical, we isolate it. So we bring it, we keep it there, bring all other terms to the other side. So x minus 3 minus x minus 1 is equal to minus 2 root x. So we have minus 4 is equal to minus 2 root x. Divide through by minus 2 to get rid of the coefficient of square root of x. So this, we have square root of x is equal to 2. Then we square both sides again to get rid of the square root. So we have x is equal to 4. X is equal to 4 is the solution. The fourth step is put x is equal to 4 into the equation to see whether it satisfies the equation. If it satisfies it, that will be the solution of that radical equation. So I want you to try the second example for me to see. I'll be going around to see how you are faring. Thank you.